there's no point of dwelling on the things that don't happen. I think you just got to put all your energy into what you do want to happen and see if you can make it. David Brooks, AFC Bournemouth. You're watching Uncut on the Premier League YouTube channel.
What were your first memories of getting scouted?
I think everyone that plays football know that you obviously go and play for your Sunday league teams, and that was just like in and around Warrington. I used to play for a team called Wolston Rovers, and near enough every summer you have the tournaments where you have the big tents and it's like seven a side. And I remember getting and picked up quite young. I think it was like under sevens, under eights. Obviously all the scouts go and look to try and find young talent and things, and thankfully I think I had a good tournament.
What were your first memories of the Premier League though?
I kind of grew up as a Man United fan, even though I was in the City Academy. I think I think the majority of boys are like that, so I wasn't a one-off. Just kind of growing up watching Man United, I think the era of like Rooney and Ronaldo is obviously captivating, and you just kind of want to watch that type of football. They were obviously big superstars.
Rooney. Possibilities here for Wayne Rooney! Straight through the goalkeeper! Wayne Rooney, the ex-Evertonian, scores in front of the cop!
Obviously, I used to get tickets and go and watch Man City quite a lot, and then they started to become real contenders for the league and things like that. And it was obviously exciting going and watching all them players like David Silva, and I've been lucky enough to watch some good teams and kind of learn off them.
David Silva, ho, ho, ho. A party piece to mark his 250th game.
Did you model your like own game on any of the players that you were watching? Like you mentioned Ronaldo, for example.
I was a late bloomer, so up until about 16, 17, I was probably about 5'2". I was skinny as out, light, slow. So it was kind of one that I was more looking towards, like the David Silvers and just pure ball control and trying to develop my game that way, because obviously I couldn't run past players, I couldn't really bully players, I couldn't really finish because I didn't have the power in my legs and things like that. So as the years have gone on, obviously you develop your game into what your strengths are at the time, and obviously I'm a completely different player to us like obviously back then. So yeah, I think obviously now you watch, I'd base my game on something completely different, but I think growing up was the David Silva type.
So at what point did you think you were going to be a Premier League footballer? At what point did you think, yeah, I'm going to make it to the Prem?
To be honest, there was never like a specific point, but I think when you look back just through like grades in school and things like that, obviously you always have it in your head like you don't need it. Like it's probably not the right thing to say for all the kids out there, but in my head, like it was just one of them things that I always wanted to be a footballer. I was at Man City's academy, and then I think it's public knowledge that it all just came crashing down at 17 years old when you get released and you're looking for a club and things, and then you're obviously looking back and thinking, oh, I should have probably done a bit better there and all that. But all my life, I've always thought I was going to be a footballer. And I think, yeah, apart from that three-week period where I got released and didn't have a club, I think I was fairly confident that I was going to do it. Thankfully, I went to Sheffield United, did all right at my trial. I think their youth team was struggling in their league at the time, and I came in, made a little bit of an impact, and they were willing to take a chance on us. So thankfully, they did. And
it worked out, that's for sure. So were there any important like individuals that have helped you? Obviously you mentioned getting released and stuff. Was there someone there that's always been to help you on this like career getting to the Premier League?
Yeah, I think obviously you look back at all your coaches and they've all definitely played a role in it. And I'd say probably the big one, even though he was trying to get me out on loan before I started playing, Chris Wilder was obviously a big one to kind of give me that chance to play. Obviously, when I came here, Eddie Howe was absolutely fantastic. I thought he was obviously one of the best coaches in the league, and obviously he's gone on to Newcastle to do great things now, and I'm sure he'll do very well there. But like obviously his time here really helped us just to kind of develop on and off the pitch. So yeah.
Well, here is a big moment for David Brooks.
So obviously you've been away from football for a little bit now. How have you like managed to keep like a positive mindset and now getting back into playing?
Yeah, I think it's just the dream, isn't it, really? I think the Premier League is what we aspire to get to, and yeah, I think that was just always playing on the back of my mind during the illness and things, to that as soon as it, I think I had about 2 weeks off after, and then literally just got straight back to work.
So what's it like now you're back?
Yeah, it's very tough. I think like it's a tough one to kind of explain, because I think people assume that like obviously I've been injured before and it doesn't take that long to get back. But whereas you look at like say the illness that I've had, it's It's more that I've done 6 months of completely nothing, so I've literally just been in bed for 6 months. So it's not like where I've done my ankle and you can kind of keep fit and do other aspects of your game and continue in the gym. You just have to stay off the ankle, whereas this is like 6 months of complete nothing. So like, all lost all the muscle, obviously put on a bunch of fat, had a bunch of different drugs obviously causing mayhem in me as well. So it was a bit of a weird and different one. I've got a lot of good people around us that are doing all the right checks and things like that, and obviously just working towards it.
So there's going to be a lot of people watching that are probably injured right now or like going through whatever, and that means they can't play football. What advice would you give to them?
Yeah, I think you just always got to keep your head up. Like, there's no, I'm fairly laid back, so I get people are probably a bit different and do worry about things, especially if like you're in a different situation with anything really, like contracts or clubs or whatever the worries are. But I think whatever will be is be. I think if you do your absolute best, then you have no regrets coming off of anything. Like, if you do your rehab properly and you do everything that you're supposed to do, eat well, then I think no matter what happens, you can look at yourself at the end of the day and say, oh, I've done everything and it's kind of not worked out. I think there's no point of dwelling on the things that don't happen. I think you just got to put all your energy into what you do want to happen and see if you can make it.
Where do you see your career in 3 years' time?
Obviously, the dream is to tick all the boxes. So hopefully, even with the cherries, we can get in Champions League. And obviously, that's something I want to aspire to do. And like I say, just tick every single box and play in every competition.